behind you. The Nipsey Hussle is right. The marathon continues. You cannot tell a hungry child that you gave him food yesterday. That's what the Zimbabwe proverb says. So I won't be long in my prayer. I won't tell you that you're not hungry, because I'm sure you are. O God, our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. God, you said wherever two or three are gathered in the midst, you're there. Whenever your spirit is, there is liberty. So as the same liberty and freedom, justice and equality that our elders, Martin King and Malcolm X and Marcus Garvey and Fred Hampton, Angela Davis, all the freedom, justice, and equality they fought, bled, and died for. It's our prayer that that same spirit reside in us. So while we're here tonight, gathered with food and fellowship, fun and entertainment, bless our hearts, touch our hearts and minds, that when we leave this place, as it says in your word, we can ask the question, did not our hearts burn? Amen. Be pleased in all that we say and all that we do. It's in your son Jesus' name that we pray. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And I'm going, and I'm stretching, and I'm growing. And I'll reap what I've been sowing, or my skin's not black. I've prayed and slaved and waited, and I've sung my song. You've bled me and you've starved me, but I've still grown strong. So whether you lash me or treat me or everything, but free me. But in time, you'll know you need me, and it won't be long. Oh, I've seen the daylight breaking high above the bough. I've found my destination and I've made my vow. So whether you deride me, abhor me, or ignore me, mighty mountains loom before me, and I won't stop now.
All right. All right.
I'd like to say thank each and everybody for coming here. Yes, the BCLC is a very strong organization.
Silence is a quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe.
Thank you.
See it may not feel like it, but I need somebody to know tonight in the bottom of your heart that the storm will pass over. My grandmother used to say, trouble don't last always. Emotional storm. I don't know if it's a relationship storm. I don't know if it's a political storm or we about to go to war. The storm will pass over here tonight. I heard a story told by an elder that said there was a village where there were two parrots, the parakeets. One lived in the west side and the other lived on the east side. And I'm from the east and west side. And the good parakeet always would wake up saying, I prayed for this. And the bad parakeet would always wake up saying, I want to make love. And one day the good parakeet keeper met the bad parakeet owner. And the bad parakeet owner said, my parakeet wakes up saying, I want to make love. And the good parakeet from East Baltimore keeper said, my parakeet wakes up saying, I love you. He said, well, maybe if you bring your good parakeet from East Baltimore to West Baltimore, maybe he may have influence. And so the good parakeet keeper brought the good parakeet to the bad parakeet, and the bad parakeet and the good parakeet were in the same room. They were in the same room at the same time. And what you think would happen didn't. And the bad parakeet woke up in the morning, and the good parakeet woke up in the morning, and the good parakeet looked at the bad parakeet, and the bad parakeet said, I want to make love. And the good parakeet said, I prayed for this moment. Turn out the light. Can I tell you tonight that I prayed for this moment as we honor Dr. King? I need you to know that this has been a... Carter G. Woodson, my frat brother, members of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, he noted that African-American contributions were overlooked, ignored, and even suppressed by writers of history textbooks and the teachers who used them. He said, race prejudice, he concluded, is merely the logical result of American tradition, the inevitable outcome of thorough instruction to the effect that the Negro has never contributed anything to the progress of mankind. But we know, even with the critical race theory on the docket, we know the truth is that there is no America without blackness. The White House without blackness. History says the summer of 1919 was the Red Summer, a time of intense racial violence that saw about 1,000 people, most of them who were black, killed between May and September 1919. In the face of widespread delusionism felt by black Americans accused by the Red Summer, Carter G. Woodson worked hard to improve the understanding of black history. Later writing, I have made every sacrifice for this moment. I have spent all of my time doing one thing and trying to do it efficiently. In the 1920s were a time of rising black self-consciousness known as the Harlem Renaissance. And the Universal Negro Improvement Association led by an extremely charismatic Jamaican immigrant, Marcus Garvey. See, black history, my brothers and sisters, is our history. Our history, often painted in lies and deceit, embedded in Eurocentric history, in the lie buried where the lies are buried. Black history is our history, and we must own it. At some point, we must own our history. It's ours. It's our narrative. We have to own it. We have to know it. And the sad reality is that we've been miseducated. Most people who don't know the truth of our history. We must own it, we must know it, and we must write it, and we must retell it. History, most of us don't know the history, so we can't tell the history. And with the CIAA's being in Baltimore, it's actually bigger than just hosting the CIAA. Can I teach you some history? Most who don't know. Most people who even attended Bowie didn't know. I was in the presidential suite with the president of Bowie State, and many alumni, they did not know this. Union Baptist Church was founded in 1852. Bowie State University was founded in 1867. Not in Prince George's County, not in Howard County, not in Baltimore County, not in Anne Arundel County, but right in downtown Baltimore. 1867, founded by a church that was built in 1852, Union Baptist Church. So I serve as the proud pastor of Union Baptist Church, and we are hosting the last stop of the CIAA tournament tomorrow with Back to Our Roots.
Amen.
See, my predecessors, I stand in some big shoes, and so my feet have to still grow. Harvey Johnson, who was one of the most notable pastors of Union Baptist Church, I don't know if you know the history of segregation on going to your research about Steamship Sue. Steamship Sue was a, there were some Stewart sisters who aborted Steamship Sue, a steamship to travel to visit their family in Virginia, and they were treated bad. They were made to leave first class and were put in second class below the steamship where the animals and the mess and the funk were. And they were members of Union Baptist Church, and Harvey Johnson brought a man by the name of William Ashby from New York down to Baltimore to become a lawyer to litigate the situation. As a result, they won that. Little do you know that the Civil Rights Movement didn't start in the 1960s. It started in the 1860s right in the city of Baltimore. Harvey Johnson, Steamship Sue. Harvey Johnson got on a train. Do you know that Baltimore owns the oldest transit system, the B&O Railroad, yeah, the first transit system? In 1906, Harvey Johnson got on the B&O Railroad trying to go to up north towards Boston, and guess what happened? They did the same thing to him, but he took it to court, and because of that, little do we know that Maryland Transit was desegregated in the 1860s, but you got black woman, a beautiful, bold, this is my daughter's affirmation, a beautiful, bold, blessed, gifted, strong, intelligent black woman. My mama raised me. Black women, we really need to honor black women, every black history, and so I honor you, to all of my black women, my black mothers and sisters, aunts. Black women history, Althea Gibson, Angela Davis, Billie Holiday, Shirley Chisholm, and Ella Fitzgerald. I could go on. But can I tell you this morning, I want to encourage you this afternoon, this evening. I want to take you back to the book of Genesis chapter 1, where God said, in the beginning, God created. And I'm going to stop with those five words, and I want to use this text to show you about what Dr. King did and how profound his work was. In the beginning, God created. Most of us jump all the way down to the Bible, to Revelation. Words. In the beginning, God created. Can I tell you really what that means? Not just that God created, but it says in the beginning, God's task. And God must remain in the middle of your time and your task. In the beginning, time, God created. God, then task. Wherever there's time, if you're breathing, you're walking, you're talking, there is a task. Keep God in the middle. See, there's a beginning and God in the middle. See, there's a beginning and there is time. And really, what God did when he created the heavens and the earth, he didn't reach for something new. He took something old. And that word create really means to separate, the pain of separation. Can you imagine the pain and the pain of separation our elders and ancestors had to endure? The pain of separation. In the beginning, God created, but there must be separation of the old in order for the birth of the new. Can I tell you what we're doing? We are birthing new black history. See, the challenge isn't just the pain of separation, but the ability to see what's ahead. We find ourselves in some dark situations, and the reality of it is, it's no different than the heavens and the earth that God created in Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. It was dark, it was formless and void, but God looked at this substance-filled place that was dark, and what's the next thing he said? He said, let there be light. There's a pain of separation, but there also must be the ability to see. See, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 2, there's some vicissitudes. There's some moving. The Bible says, and the Spirit of God hovered over the face of the waters. The water was moving, the water was alive, and the water was active. History tells us of the journey of God and God's people to freedom. Freedom, oh freedom, we shall overcome. Dr. King said this. He said, Carlyle was right, that truth crushed to the ground shall rise again. Can I tell you what that truth was? That truth was my ancestors, my elders, my grandmother, my grandfather, you and your family. Truth crushed to the ground. How many times have they tried to put their foot on our necks, but we keep getting up? Vicissitudes, the ups and downs, the peaks and the valleys. Dr. King said this. These aren't my words. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. I want to tell you three things that Dr. King teaches us in order how to keep moving forward and fighting for justice. The first is vision, the second is voice, and the last thing is victory. Dr. King said, I had a dream. He had a vision. I remember being a kid, Dr. King had a vision. He had a dream. He said, we've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter to me now, because I've been to the mountaintop and I had a vision. Amen. Of the promised land. Yes. And this is what our ancestors and our elders should have told us, and what my ancestors
bosses tell me and my elders tell me, I may not get there with you, but guess what? We're going to make it to the promised land. Do you know where you are tonight? You are in the promised land. It may not look like it. It may not feel like it, but you're in God's promised land. How do I know this? Because you're alive and well. You got breath in your body. You wake up to see another day. You're in the promised land. You need vision. See, vision, God said, let there be light. And where there is no vision, you will always become victims of your circumstance. Can I tell you that you can make your circumstance? That you got to have some vision. You got to have some insight. I ain't talking about eyesight. You got to have some vision. See, vision just isn't insight or eyesight. Vision is knowledge, and we die because of the lack of knowledge. These are Dr. King's words, not mine. He said, I have a dream. Can I tell you that America has a bad vision? A bad vision. We got bad vision. They may have good eyesight, but they got poor insight. Because if they knew, like the children of Israel in Egypt, that the more they persecuted them, the more they grew. And can I tell you why we here today? Why you can listen to a 33-year-old black man from East Baltimore? Because the more they persecuted us, the more we keep growing. And can I encourage you, those with children, the more they persecute you, the more you will keep growing. Dr. King said, I had a dream. You need some vision. And we know what else he said? He said, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, keep moving forward. And if you got vision, you can keep moving forward. It says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. I can speak things not as though they are, but as though they shall be. You got to have some vision. You got to have some voice, because you got to tell the world what God said. We got some good news. Didn't Sam Cooke say that? I got some good news. You may not be able to see it with your eyes, but you ought to be able to see it with your heart. Dr. King said, I have a dream. I've been to the mountaintop, and I can see the promised land. Can you see the promised land? I'm walking in my promised land, and I sat there this evening, and I was listening, and I started crying, and I started thinking about all the storms I've been through, all the chains my ancestors had to be bound by coming from the shores of Africa, all the hog, mog, and pig feet that was left outside of the master's house, all the food they didn't want, all my aunts and great-grandmothers that were raped by the master. The storm is passing over. You may not have some vision, but you ought to have some voice, and when you put your voice with your vision, there is something called V-I-C-T-O-R-Y. Can I tell you why you're here tonight? Because our ancestors did not go to the grave without victory. We got the victory. My grandmother thought she would never see a black president. We got the victory. We got our children standing in the streets saying, Black Lives Matter. I'm out your way. And all I want you to know is when I was a kid in school, I walked into my history class and my American government class and all my social studies class, and I looked at the top of the room, and all I would see is 41 and 42 white men, and I got pissed. I had not math phobia, I had history phobia. But then I went to a school called Morehouse, and Morehouse showed me who I am, that I'm young, gifted, and black, that I am somebody. When you ain't got vision, you ought to have some voice. Do I have anybody here tonight that can say something, that I'm black and I'm proud? Don't you know?
That's when things start happening. When I stop looking at back then, and I let go, when I let God have His way. I couldn't seem to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind, searching for that peace, but the peace I could not find. So then I kneeled down to pray. Pray and help me, please. He said, you won't have to cry, because I'll supply all your needs. As soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, and I let go and I let God, let God have his way, that's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then, and I let go and I let God have his way.
I'm a candidate for Maryland's 10th Legislative District here. I'm 20 years old, running to be the youngest Democratic legislator in our state's history. When the pastor talked about Black history and how it's always construed, Dr. King came to my mind. He is the embodiment of the political radicalism of love. He deeply understood what it actually meant to love thy neighbor and taught millions through his actions. King dedicated his life to organize and fight against all systems of oppression, violence, and exploitation. He risked his life and organized radical acts of civil disobedience to topple Jim Crow and the systemic racism still present in our society today. He fought to expand the right to vote and engage citizens in civic action. Though, let us not forget, he was deeply unpopular when he was alive. He was ostracized by most of the country and murdered in an act of hate. Many treat Black History Month and use it as a way to make false tributes and just use it as fluff. But what we have to remember is that we can't blur his legacy. We need to make it a time of reflection, a time of meditation between our own beliefs and the calls to the actions of Dr. King. History has been rewritten and to exclude and distort the radicalism of his legacy because it doesn't fit the narrative of the status quo. It calls for further mobilization against political and economic elites, those who fight for human rights, who believe in human dignity for all, who organize for material change, will always be labeled political radicals. Voting rights aren't radical. Living wages aren't radical. Justice reform aren't radical. Universal housing and healthcare aren't radical. It's what our communities need and it's what our futures deserve. So let us all work to never stop imagining the amazing things we can accomplish when we love instead of hate, reach out instead of draw back, listen instead of counter, and organize instead of factionalize. So thank you so much, everybody. I hope you have a great evening. Thank you.
Liza, bless the Lord.
Yes.
Don't you know the days of Roy? If you don't get up, you scamp. There'll be trouble with this camp. You think I'm going to let you sleep while you make your bone keep? That's a pity how they do. Don't you hear me, Liza, you? I bet if I come across this blow, you won't buy no time to snuff. Baby, that's all that shine in how you sleep while it's a sin. But you go the morning through, burning up the daylight too. Liza, don't you hear me call? No use to turn towards that wall. I can hear that mattress squeak. Don't you hear me when I speak? This year clock the stroke of six. Caroline, bring me them dust sticks. Oh, you shy, how you down. Look here, boy, don't dare to frown. You march yourself and you wash your face. And don't you splat all over the place. I got something else to do. Size just cleaning out for you. You take that comb and you comb your head. It looks just like a better bed. Come here, boy, I'll let you see. You shame roll your eyes at me. You have felt yourself too strong. And you surely got me wrong. You sit down at that table there, and you just a ripper if you dare. Even moaning on this place, seems like I must lost my grace. You fold your hands, and you bow your head, and you wait until the blessing said. Lord have mercy on our souls. Don't you dare to touch your rolls. That's the food we want to eat. You sit still, I seize your beat. You just try the trick again. Give us peace and joy, amen. Amen.
the shout outs that I would like to do before I perform with you all. I would like to give a shout out to Dr. Scott for inviting me to come and to share my gift. You dig? In the good book, Proverbs 18:16, it says, a man's gift will make room for him and bring them in front of great men. Or should I say great men and women. Ancestors align me with the truth. The way we shift time is the proof. I'm a wordsmith, baby. I conjure magic in the booth. Rebirth a nation with a noose. Move team like pineapple juice. The eagle slows progress like a toll booth. R.I.P. Chuck Brown, I feel like busting loose. Plate full of Goman, dreams full of omens. We in Rome, so we play like the Romans. Kimonos and Shinjuku, Lee Morgan Brew. Astrosonic duo, we appearing too. So what, Freddie was a freeloader. We blue and green. God validated, so we just showed up on the scene. I mean what I say, and I say what I mean. Water from own cistern, the best vaccine. Bebop before hip-hop, blues before jazz. Bebop before hip-hop, blues before jazz. Bebop before hip-hop, blues before jazz. Natives before Americans, the truth is in my stash. I'm riding in the car with Tracy Chapman so fast. Sipping coconut water because we just broke fast. Rain water collected on the roof. Ancestors align me with the truth. The way we shift time is the proof. Wordsmith, I conjure magic in the booth. Yeah. Rebirth the nation with a noose. Move team like pineapple juice. The eagle slows progress like a toll booth. R.I.P. Chuck Brown, I feel like busting loose. I said, Duke Ellington align me with the truth. I said, Count Basie align me with the truth. I said, Ella Fitzgerald align me with the truth. I said, Betty Carter align me with the truth. I said, Sarah Vaughan align me with the truth. I said, Billie Holiday align me with the truth. I said, Miles Davis align me with the truth. I said, Charlie Parker align me with the truth. I said, John Coltrane align me with the truth. I said, Max Roach align me with the truth. I said, Charlie Christian align me with the truth. I said, Paul Robeson align me with the truth. I said, Malcolm X align me with the truth. I said, Martin Luther King align me with the truth. I said, my mom align me with the truth. I said, hey, we align you with the truth. I
I'm not afraid. feces, urine, the worst kind of foods being thrown at us, our women raped at will, and our men. We get here, foreign land, we're not able to use our language, but the songs that we sang kept us sane. What we now know as hymns evolved from the songs from the cotton fields. 12 to 16 hours, Dean Scott. No hot and cold running water. To the elders, you remember your parents and grandparents. Bathroom in the backyard. No hot and cold running water. Children born not in hospital, at house. Wasn't that long ago. But through prayer and song and dance and faith and love, we're still here. Monday they will say that the first black woman, 400 years, will be a Supreme Court justice. They say her experience is second to none. We're still here.